To understand the political adventure of Berlusconi, we have to go back to the last decades, to the Italian change, the political change in Italy of the last decades, and starting with 1992, the Clean Hands and the Bright City process, when many of Italian political leaders were arrested, and when most of Italian old political parties completely disappeared from the political scene. If you don't place Berlusconi within this framework, Clean Hands Fest in 1992, and then the disappearance of all traditional political structures in Italy, you don't understand what Berlusconi means and why he has been able to win the Italian election and why he's still an Italian prime minister. You have to place Berlusconi within this political framework. And also within the framework of the post-Berlin Wall, which completely changed the international location in Italy in connection to the larger existence of Communist Party. So in some way, you have to understand Berlusconi within a much larger interpretive framework that cannot be limited just to exoticism, curiosity, corruption, sexual abuse, or whatever you like. But there are political reasons, there are political and political framework within which you have to place Berlusconi and his political architecture. The main consequences of the 1992 bribery city and when most of Italian political leaders were arrested is the fact that in 1994 there was a political map. What means there was a political map? And here the first novelty of the story arrives. That the old party structures that were based on ideology, on affiliation code, a sort of affiliation link that bound together citizens, voters and party structure disappeared. There were voters who were looking for parties to vote because the symbol of their party, the party that they voted for decades, were not anymore on the ballot because those parties have disappeared. So there were voters, citizens, looking for shall I vote for who? And Berlusconi was able to appear on the political scene as an appealing leader for those voters who were looking for their new party which to vote for. There was a vacuum at the center of the political, Italian political landscape. There was a vacuum essentially at the center of Italian political, not on the right, not on the left side, but at the very center of Italian political spectrum, there was a vacuum, and Berlusconi has been able to fill that vacuum that started in 1992-1994 when the old political party structure in Italy completely disappeared. Which were the instruments of Berlusconi to fill that thing? A new party, Forza Italia, that he established essentially thanks to market research, to survey research. Something that in Italy was not used at all. Because there was no need for market research, because there were strong links between voters and party staff. Voters did not change their vote. The party they voted for was their sort of religious affiliation party. They were not used before 1994 to change their vote. They were not able to change their vote because there were these strong ideological links. And instead, in 1994, there were a party. And Berlusconi was going to be able to understand what was going on thanks to market research and essentially thanks to Sarah. Of course, being the owner the major Italian private conglomerate helped a lot, used a lot of television, but not just because it was the owner of those television. He has been able to understand the television culture. So there are two different elements. He was the owner of television, but essentially he understood, he was able to understand much better than the others what television needed. And this is what I guess Dennis and also Zasuski